أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today in 110 Lessons for Life from the Commander of the Faithful Imam Ali, may God's peace and blessings be upon him, we turn our attention to being diverted from the right path. Now without a doubt, as Muslims at least, we recognize the fact that at least 10 times a day we proclaim to God, we ask God, we implore our Creator by saying اهدنَا الصراط المستقيم, to guide me or keep me, or guide us rather, or keep us on the straight path. This is something that we ask for every day, 10 times a day in the minimum. It should be a wake-up call that if we are asking God for this guidance, either to become on the straight path or to stay on that straight path, that this is one of the most important responsibilities as Muslims that we have. Because obviously from this path can lead many other avenues of felicity, and straying from this path, as God refers to in the Quran, can also lead to many problems and downfalls of the human being. So before we go into a further analysis, let us have a look at this tradition and have a read of it, and then we'll come back and have a brief analysis of what the Commander of the Faithful means by this statement that he has been that he has mentioned that is recalled in our books of traditions. The Imam says the following statement: if only you were to contemplate upon the magnificent power of God and the adequate blessings from Him, you would have returned back to the right path and would have feared the burning punishment. However, your hearts are sick and your spiritual sight is deficient. So in this tradition, the Commander of the Faithful gives us a reason why people tend to leave the path. When we go to the Quran and we look at how Islam gives us an understanding of humanity, we can actually categorize people into one of three categories. And this is something which we see basically in Surah Al-Fatiha, chapter number 1 of the Noble Quran, in which God tells us that we have people who are on the straight path. And this is the first group of humanity, people who are the believers, who are on the straight path, who do not waver on that path, who follow all of the obligations which they have been instructed to do, keep away from the prohibitions, and basically lead a life of respect and nobility. That is the first group. The second group, however, and we categorize two separate categories of people into the second group, as God does in Surah Al-Fatiha, where He mentions these two groups independently. I just want to group them together. He talks about people who have earned the wrath of God, those who have been reprimanded and chastised by God for their own actions, their own acts of iniquity. And also a second portion of this second group are those who have completely gone astray, who don't follow any divine religion, who just lead life as maybe a secularist, who don't follow divinely sent teachings. This is a second group of individuals. So first group are the believers, second are those who are either deviants or who are completely off of the path. And the third group we can say, and it's not mentioned in chapter number 1, Surah Al-Fatiha, but the third group that we want to refer to are those who are sometimes between the two. Right? Sometimes they're good people, they do good actions, they follow the mandates of the religion, and sometimes they fall off of the beaten track. Sometimes they slip, they make mistakes, they make blunders in their life, they have a lapse of judgment. But all in all, they're good people, but sometimes they end up falling down onto from that straight path. So really, these are the three groups of humanity that we see on the earth today. Now, how do we understand these three in the light of this particular tradition is the question. In reality, the Commander of the Faithful in this tradition tells us that those who have been misled off of the path, that there is still room for them to come back. I mean, really, there's room for everybody. The mercy of God is spacious. There's room for everybody to return back to the Creator and to make amends for their actions. But the Commander of the Faithful is pointing us to a reality where that third group, those who are sometimes wavering, they're on the path, they slip, they come back, He is speaking to them directly, and He says that were you to only use your intellect to think about God's greatness, to think about the blessings which God has showered upon each and every one of us, that this in the beginning would be one of the ways for us to return back to the path of servitude of God. And so a level one is for you and I to think, and to always be in a constant level of thought. You know, many times we don't have time to think, or so we feel, that we're busy with work. We're just busy doing things, running around, shopping, work, school, this and that. And we don't really sincerely have time to sit and think and reflect on the greatness of God, to think about the blessings that He has given us once we've strayed off of that path. The Commander of the Faithful tells us that this is the initial stage of returning back to God, is to sit and reflect and contemplate and meditate, if you want to call it that, or think on what God has done for each and every one of us. In the close of this hadith, and as we close this discussion, the Commander of the Faithful tells us why we don't sometimes have that divinely granted opportunity to sit and think. He tells us that maybe your hearts are sick. There is a disease, a poison in the heart. And that sickness does not allow us that opportunity to sit and think and reflect on what God has done for each and every one of us. And he also says because our spiritual sight, our spiritual insight is very short-sighted. We don't have, and we don't maybe try to look into the future, look into where we will be. We don't think about our outcome on the day of judgment. Because of these two factors, he says that, you know, we don't have that opportunity to always turn back to God. And so as we close, we have to realize that we need to, if we find a sickness in our hearts, we need to work at the remedy and the cure of that sickness. Maybe it's love of the material world, maybe it's love of power, of authority, of many different things. We have to remove and curtail that. We have to be able to cure the sickness of our heart, and we may need to go to a spiritual doctor for that, for them to give us the guidance and teachings on how to cure that problem. And also we need to increase our foresight, look into the future, so to speak, think about our outcome, think about where we are headed as an individual. And hopefully through these two actions and the power of reflection, contemplation, we will come back to the path if we found ourselves straying off the path towards God. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.